Hey guys, it is me and welcome back to the start of a brand new reading vlog. Today is Tuesday, September 22nd. I did take a couple of clips yesterday but actually didn't get to open the vlog properly because I was super busy with schoolwork and everything like that. So I don't really have like a TBR for this week, only to finish Blood and Honey. I'm really excited to finish this book. I hit part two yesterday, which everybody had said how part one was really boring and part two is where it kind of got good. I found part one good, so hopefully it just is phenomenal in part two. Today I would like to read the entirety of part two, but whether that's going to happen or not, we shall see. I've been reading this for almost a week. I started this last Thursday, so I would like to finish it fairly soon so that I can move on to some other books. I got two books in the mail yesterday. One of them was The Bone Houses and one of them was Sarah's Key. And I think there's another book coming in the mail today, but it's like, it's for my nan, but she doesn't want it right now. She wants it like in it, like for Christmas or something, but she told me to read it first. So, I mean, I'm probably not going to wait till Christmas to give it to her, but I'm going to read it first and then give it to her. It was a large print edition of a historical fiction. So yeah, apart from finishing Blood and Honey, I don't really have that many plans for the week. Today is the autumn equinox, so at 2:30 today, it's officially autumn, and honestly, I'm ready. I miss summer kind of because it was so warm and so like free, but because I'm doing online classes, I mean, I'm not dreading the incoming winter because I don't have to get up at like 6:30 to grab a bus in the pouring rain, pitch black morning. That just doesn't seem... that's not it, you know, but I don't mind so much if it rains if I'm inside, you get me? Yesterday was such a warm day and I feel like it was gonna be like the last warm day. I'm just going to stop talking, do my assignments for the day, and hopefully read some of Blood and Honey. I had this idea for a 24-hour readathon a little while ago, and the reason that I want to do it soon is because I actually have the audiobooks for two of the books on my library, on BorrowBox. So I have this series by Maris Kleitzman. It's like the Once series, and I think there's like five books, but they're all pretty small, and I was going to attempt to read all of those in 24 hours. So I might do that. I've read the first one in school and I'm like in the middle of the second one, so I kind of want to do that readathon today because, like, you know, to celebrate autumn coming in, but also I'm reading Blood and Honey, so I could just like dedicate my day to finishing this. But that's a lot because there's like 400 pages left. But yeah, that is all I want to say. I read quite a lot of Blood and Honey today, like maybe about 50 pages, and I do want to read more. I ideally would like to get up to part three today, but I don't think that's possible unless I like stay reading well into the night, but you never know what could happen. I am loving this, by the way, like it's amazing. Full five-star feels already. I did get two books in the mail today, and I guess they're not like the most exciting books, but they're books, and this is a reading vlog, so here we go. So the first one's actually for school and it is Foster by Claire Keegan. I'm not very excited about this, but it is like 86 pages or something, so I mean, it's not gonna be too much of a chore to get through. This is like about like this foster child who lives in rural Ireland, and I don't know, something happens, I don't know. This just sounds really boring and I'm not really excited for it, but you know, required reading. We love that. I just don't like books set in Ireland, which is really weird because I'm Irish and very proud to be Irish, but I just don't really like Irish setting books. I like to, you know, be transported into a different place, you know? And the next book is actually for my nan that I should read it first. So it is Daughter of the Reich by Louise Fine, and then this is a World War II historical fiction, as you could probably tell, but guys, look at the size of this book. Like, compared, I know this is an exceptionally short book, but even compared to Blood and Honey, it's like huge. This is a large print edition, which means like there's really, really large words on the page, so it should be like a fast read because you know, I'm used to much smaller words on pages, but it's big. It's like 700 and something pages. Love that for me, but it does look really interesting and I cannot wait, and it is like a really floppy paperback. I feel like this would be a book that I'd annotate if I weren't passing it on, obviously, so Yeah, I'm really excited. So they are the two books that I received today. I don't know if I showed you properly the books that I received yesterday. Okay, so I think I did like a time lapse of me opening these packages, but just so I could like show you the actual books, I got two books in the post yesterday. One of them was Sarah's Key, which is a World War II historical fiction where she's like on the path from Amsterdam, no, from Paris to Auschwitz to find her brother. And that just sounds so harrowing, but also something that that's exactly what I want to be reading. I just love these settings of books, even though they're so, like, they tear me apart and I can't read one after the other because I get so invested in the characters' lives and the books themselves. But yeah, I love it. And then the other one that I got is The Bone Houses by Emily Lloyd Jones, and this is a hardcover. I've been living for hardcovers lately, even though they're so expensive and I barely have any, and my channel name is literally Perfect Paperbacks. So The Bone Houses, and this is like about a girl who like works in a graveyard, or her family like runs a graveyard or something, but there's some weird, I don't know, her family in her family's graveyard, and there's like they're in danger or something. So that sounds really interesting, and it's not too long. So I do have a book recommendations video coming soon. It might be up by the time this vlog is up, but it just sounds really amazing and I cannot wait to read it in October, spooky season. Also, today is officially the first day of autumn. It is the autumn equinox at 2:30 on the button, which is when it said it was the official autumn equinox. Me and my mum started listening to Halloween songs because we love it, and yeah, I'm really excited. So my plans for the night are to edit about 10 more minutes of my video because it's a really long one and edits take me forever, and read maybe 50 more pages of this, maybe 100, I don't know. That's a little bit ambitious, but yes, I'm really excited. Have a great night and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Hi guys, happy Thursday. Well, I hope it's a happy Thursday for you guys. It is now 5:30 in the evening, so it's actually Thursday evening, but I've had a day, like not necessarily a bad day, just like a long day. I had lots of assignments to do today, and also then in the afternoon we had to bring Misty to the vet. She's totally fine, she just has like the infection and she just needed a couple injections and antibiotic, so she's all good and she is chilling on the sofa right now. I did get one book in the mail today and I'm going to show you. I pre-ordered this a couple weeks ago. I think I pre-ordered it the day before it came out, but it must have been like out of stock or something because I only received it today. But anyways, it is Legendborn by Tracy Dion, and this looks amazing. I actually, like, look at the gloss of this cover, an urban fantasy type of thing. It looks really great, and I was like, okay, it's a normal sized book, it's not too thick, not too thin, you know, a good decent story sized. Then I looked at the size of the writing. Bro, how much eyesight do you think I have? Like, I have good eyesight, but this is gonna take me a long time to read, I already know. And it's already like 500 pages. Honestly, I might have a nap. Hey guys, so it is now 6:30 and I've just made myself a vanilla latte to enjoy. And I'm reading Blood and Honey. I'm on page 350 and I suppose I can just like give you my update and my thoughts right now. I've been reading this for a week. I started this last Thursday and I'm just gonna be completely honest, it's not my favorite. I don't know whether it's the fact that there's something that I'm not enjoying or whether it's the fact that it's taken me a week to read and I'm still like only halfway through. I don't know what it is about this. I don't want to give any spoilers because obviously this is a new release and also like it's a sequel. So I just don't really like the direction that they're going in and the kind of like spin that they're putting. But I don't know, do I like it, because I don't know how it's going to end. But if it ends the way that I think it could end, I will really not be happy. I don't know, it's just there's something about it. I'm not 100% in love with all of the characters this time around, which is really sad and disappointing, even though I'm still loving this book. And I know I said like a couple of negative things, but like this is an amazing book and I'm loving the like atmosphere of like the French and kind of like cozy autumn vibes. Like even when they're like casting spells, their magic system is super fucked up and super weird and I don't think I like it, but like even when they're like casting spells, like smells of cinnamon and stuff come into the air, and it's just very like autumnal. But at the same time, I don't know, like I feel like I shouldn't rate it any lower than 5 stars because I'm so excited for this book, but I don't know, it all depends on how it like ends up. So I'm on page 350 and there's like 550, so I have like 200 pages left. I really want to finish it tonight, like I'm just, it's been dragging on for too long and I just want to know how it ends, because anytime that I'm thinking about reading I'm kind of like, oh, do I have to pick this up? But I do. So yeah, I have the audiobook and I was listening to the audiobook while I was doing a couple other things, but it's not a great audiobook, and I don't know if I'm the only person who's had problems with Scribd lately. I use Scribd a lot, but like it takes forever to load and there's like skipping problems and it keeps like just shutting off for no reason. Like, am I the only one with this problem? Because it's not, it doesn't need to be update. Oh, why does my hair look like Belle from Beauty and the Beast? We love that for me. But it's like, it's not my phone because I've updated it quite a few times and like updated Scribd anytime that I could. But it just doesn't seem to be working that great, and it's really frustrating because even though like I consider Scribd to be like free books because you can have as you can read as many as you want in a month, like I'm still paying for that subscription service, so it should be working. Anywho, I'm going to stop talking, read as much as I possibly can until my mom comes home, because when she comes home we have to do the dishes, but then we're gonna watch Enola Holmes. It came out yesterday or today, I believe, and it just looks really, really good. And you know, Millie Bobby Brown is quite iconic. It is now Sunday morning at like 9 a.m. but I've been awake since like 7, and I'm sorry that it's dark, but the blinds are broken and I can't lift them up. So I'm in my nana's house right now and I've been watching Books with Chloe's 24-hour readathons all morning. It's making me want to do a 24-hour readathon because, I mean, I don't actually have classes tomorrow. Tomorrow is the school is closed, which is amazing because even though I could probably do it because I'm doing online school, I don't want to have to take so many breaks of reading to do schoolwork, and I'm not going to ignore my schoolwork to read. So yeah, it's really perfect. So I'm either going to do it tonight and recover tomorrow from the readathon, or do it tomorrow. And I'm not really sure of which, but I'm really excited to do that. So I'm going to go downstairs right now and get some breakfast. The book that I'm currently reading is The Bone Houses by Emily Lloyd-Jones. It's really good so far. I'm only like 20 something pages in, but I think it's a horror book. And I thought it was a fantasy, but I think it's horror, and I'm going to get so spooked, but I'm just going to DNF it if I'm not liking it or if it's too scary because I'm a wimp. Plus, I have like 30 plus books on my Halloween TBR, so I need to get through them fairly fast. I finished Blood and Honey Friday night and I didn't really update you. So in the end, I actually ended up reading the last like quarter in one sitting. I just read, and it was really intense. I really did enjoy it and I ended up giving it 5 stars, even though there were a couple of things that I didn't particularly love, like the ending I'm a little bit conflicted on, because I don't know, I feel like it kind of undid everything and every bit of progress that we'd made throughout the book, and it set it up for the third book, yes, which comes out next August, and I already can't wait. Like, even though I didn't adore this one, I still can't wait for book three. And like, it set it up for book three, but I feel like book three is gonna go into this in so much detail and so much freaking, like, it's gonna take the whole book and not be solved until the end, which I don't like. And obviously I want to be very vague because I don't want to give any spoilers about the book for those of you who have not read it or do want to read it. But if you have read it and you know the ending, just DM me on Instagram, because don't put any spoilers in the comments, but let me know what you thought of the ending, because I don't know, like, I'm conflicted. I am conflicted. Like, I don't know. But I did still give it 5 stars because my overall enjoyment of the book and the atmosphere of the book was amazing. And I can't rate it less than 5 stars, even though there were certain things that I didn't particularly enjoy. But I think a little bit of the reason that I didn't enjoy those things is because it took me over a week to read. And if you know me, you know I don't like to take very long on the one book because I start to lose interest and I start to get bored, which is really bad. But like, yeah. So I'm going to continue reading The Bone Houses and try to make a little bit of progress, because whenever I start my readathon, I am going to end this vlog right now, by the way, too. This is the end of this vlog. But I want to make a couple of progress on The Bone Houses because I kind of want to either finish it today or DNF it today because I'm just over it. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this vlog. I hope you enjoyed, and comment down below your... We'll go for the ghost emoji this time. Comment the ghost emoji if you watched this far, because you know we're in the spooky vibes. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Like and comment and subscribe if you want to, and I will see you again very soon in the next video. Bye guys.